जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड फूड्स और जेनेटिकली इंजीनियर्ड फूड्स आर फूड्स प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट हैव हैड चेंजेस इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इनटू देयर डीएनए यूजिंग द मेथड्स ऑफ जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग. Advances in plant biotechnology have made it possible to identify and modify genes controlling specific characteristics. Nowadays, scientists can transfer genes from one organism to another unrelated organism, producing what is known as genetically modified organism or transgenic animal or transgenic plant. More technically, genetically engineered food are defined as foods produced from plants, animals and microbes that have had their genetic code modified by the selective introduction of specific DNA segments. This process allows the organism to acquire a desired trait such as pest protection, herbicide resistance or improved nutritional qualities. The enhancement of desired trait has traditionally been undertaken through breeding, but conventional plant breeding methods can be very time consuming and are often not very accurate. Some of the peculiar features which would define GM foods are the foods that contain an added gene sequence or that have a deleted gene sequence, or the animal produced from animals fed GM feed, or products produced by GM organisms or genetically modified organisms. Now let's check the history of GM foods. In the 1960s, it was proven that this knowledge had the potential to revolutionize the food production, thus creating huge benefits for the world. By 1972, another scientific breakthrough was recorded by Paul Berg, who joined together DNA from two different organisms to create the first recombinant DNA molecule. This breakthrough was followed by a pioneer study in which Stanley Cohen and Robert Boyer inserted DNA from an African cloud toad into an Escherichia coli bacterium. Shortly after then, some companies realized that this fledgling technology could open up new highly profitable markets. Between 1960s to 1970, isolation of restriction enzymes and their use to analyze DNA structure was found out, and between 81 to 82, first transgenic mice was produced. Between 83 and 85, first transgenic plants were produced, and in 90 to 92, first transgenic cereal plants were, like maize and wheat, were produced. And in between 92 and 93, regulations for deliberate release of genetically engineered organisms was released, and the commercial sale of genetically modified foods began in 1994. The genetically engineered tomato was marketed in USA and it was named Flavor Saver. Types of genetically modified foods. The first generation crops, they have enhanced input traits such as herbicide tolerance, better insect resistance and better tolerance to environmental stress. These crops are not significantly different from the traditional grown crops in terms of appearance, taste and nutrition. Examples of such crops are herbicide resistant soybean, insect resistant maize and herbicide and insect resistant potato. Second generation crops, they have new traits to increase their benefits to consumers such as increased levels of protein, modified or healthier fats, modified carbohydrates, increased flavor or increased micronutrients. Examples of such crops include rice with a higher level of beta carotene, that is a golden rice, and the tomatoes with higher levels of carotenoids, maize with increased vitamin C and soybean with improved amino acid composition, and potatoes with higher calcium content. Next is the third generation food. These plants may have traits that can provide increased ability to resist abiotic stresses such as drought, increased temperature or saline soils. Other traits may provide health benefits, yet another objective may be to create pharma plants to help produce active pharmaceutical products. In February 2009, the US Food and Drug Administration approved the license for a recombinant antithrombin for prevention of blood clots in patients with hereditary antithrombin deficiency. Recombinant antithrombin is the first human biologic drug derived from the milk of goats that have been genetically engineered to produce human antithrombin in their milk. There are three main types of genetically modified food technique. The first one is inserting genes or gene shifting. Here the genes are determined by different DNA sequences. When the isolated gene is inserted into a plant, it becomes part of the plant gene and works with its own function. This method can increase or improve the plant's resistance to insect, which increases the yield of food afterwards. And the second method is removing genes or gene silencing. For example, the function of virus which causes dried and spot of tomato is reduced by removing the part of the gene. Thus, the virus cannot be reproduced and tomato can grow healthily. And the third method is changing the process of catabolism or gene splicing. In this, the food can be enhanced by changing the process of catabolism, such as controlling the percentage of starch of glutinous rice, and it also includes controlling the taste, mass, color, and usefulness of food. The process for genetic modification has some important steps. To begin with, isolation of the gene of interest. A chromosome is used to identify the gene responsible for the desired trait in the organism. And the insertion of the gene into a transfer vector. The desired trait is put into the plasmid. And then is the plant transformation. The plasmid contained inside the agrobacterium tumefaciens cells transfer the plasmids and new gene into the plant's chromosomes. Then is the selection of the modified plant cells. Selectable marker genes are used to favor the growth of the cells containing the trait. Next is the regeneration of the plant into whole plant via tissue culture. And in this steps, they take explants onto media containing nutrients that lead to the development of cells and that form plantlets that once rooted are put into in a controlled environmental conditions for the growth. And next is the verification of transformation characterization of the inserted DNA fragment. The tests are done to determine the number of copies if intact and doesn't interfere with other genes. And these tests are done to see if the gene is functional. And the next step is the testing of the plant performance. Here we see or test and see if the resulted plant grown in a greenhouse has acquired the favored traits and if it has any unwanted characteristics. The last one is the safety assessment. More tests carried out to see whether the plant's performance and environmental safety assessments and other safety assessments are also done. Common genetically modified foods include soybean, corn and sugar, wheat. These are resistant to glyphosate, a major content of the herbicide, by inserting herbicide-resistant gene. Then there's the cottonseed oil by inserting pest-resistant BT crystal protein gene from Bacillus thuringiensis. Then there's the tomato by removing the gene that codes for polyglutaminase. It's an enzyme that is responsible for softening of fruits after harvesting. Then potatoes have been also been genetically modified. Then rapeseed with high oleic acid content by adding the new genes. And rice, that is the example is the golden rice. It is made high with vitamin A by inserting genes from daffodils. Let's see what's happening in golden rice. It was created by Inco Portricus. The golden rice is a variety of rice produced through genetic modification to biosynthesize the precursor of beta-carotene, pro-vitamin A, in the edible parts of rice. More than 120 million children in the world suffer from vitamin A deficiency. Golden rice has the potential to help prevent the 1 to 2 million deaths each year caused by deficiency in this vitamin. Golden rice was created by incorporating rice with two beta-carotene biosynthesis genes. From daffodils, it's namely Psi, the phytoene synthase, and lycopene cyclase. Here you can see the beta carotene pathway in golden rice. Here the geranium geranyl diphosphate, in the presence of phytoene synthase, is converted to phytoene, then to zeta carotene by phytoene desaturase gene. And this zeta carotene is converted into lycopene, and from lycopene, with the help of lycopene cyclase, it is lyse gene, which is derived from daffodils, will be converting it into beta carotene, and this beta carotene is a precursor for vitamin A. Next one is a cold tolerant tomatoes. Scientists have created a frost-resistant tomato plant by adding an antifreeze gene from a cold water fish to it. And the antifreeze genes come from the cold water fish named flounder, and they can survive in very cold condition. The flounder has a gene to make chemical antifreeze, and this is removed from the antifreeze DNA and is joined into a piece of DNA called the plasmid. And this hybrid DNA, which is a combination of DNA from two different sources, is known as the recombinant DNA. Next one is the vitamin-rich tomatoes. Here, we are using Agrobacterium, which can naturally infect plants by causing various diseases. By replacing that infecting gene with desirable ones, will be resulting into new genetic makeup with advantageous traits. The bright orange color of carrots come from beta carotene, which work as a precursor of the synthesis of vitamin A in our body. So by inserting this color gene into the tomato, it will enhance its appearance as well as its vitamin A level to the desired level. Next is the protein-enriched potatoes for NASA. Potato is a non-cereal food crop limited in the amount of lysine, tyrosine, methanol and cytosine amino acids. To provide sufficient protein and amino acid to astronauts with their complete nutrition requirements, a tuber-specific protein amalgam seed albumin, that is AMA1, has been used to transform potatoes. The AMA1 protein has a well-balanced amino acid profile. In fact, its amino acid composition exceeds value recommended by the WHO for a nutritionally rich protein. This protein was used due to its non-allergenicity in its purified form. When the AMA1 gene was inserted into a potato, 2.5 to 4-fold increase in lysine, tyrosine, methionine and cytosine content and 35 to 45% increase in total protein content was reported in transgenic tubers. BT soybean. The two target insects for insect-resistant transgenic soybeans are the velvet bean caterpillar and the soybean looper. Scientists have incorporated Bacillus thuringiensis gene into soybean, which has insecticidal protein that maintain the yield of the crop. Bacillus thuringiensis is a ubiquitous soil bacterium, is a source of gene for insect resistance. In genetically modified corn, the traits that have been engineered is the resistance to herbicides and resistance to insect pests. Here, the gene that code for BT toxin has been incorporated. Corn varieties resistant to glyphosate herbicides have been produced. Pioneer Hybrid has marketed corn hybrids with tolerance to imidazoline herbicides under the trademark Clear Field. The papaya cultivation is threatened by papaya ring spore virus, a disease that sharply lowers the fruit yield. The University of Hawaii developed a ring spore virus disease-resistant papaya, and to do this, certain viral genes encoding capsid proteins were transferred to the papaya genome. And these viral capsid proteins elicit something similar to an immune response from the papaya plant. The first resistant papaya varieties were grown commercially in 1999 in Hawaii. These genetically modified papayas are approved for consumption both in US and in Canada. Just like the genetically modified fruit, there are genetically modified organisms. An organism whose genetic material has been altered using genetic engineering techniques is termed as genetically modified organism. An organism that have been genetically modified include microorganisms such as bacteria, yeast, plants, fish and mammals. When genes are inserted, they usually come from a different species, which is a form of horizontal gene transfer. In nature, this can occur when exogenous DNA penetrates the cell's membrane for any reason. To do this artificially may require attaching the genes to a virus or just physically inserting the extra DNA into the nucleus of the intended host with a very small syringe or with very small particles fired from a gene gun. Agrobacterium's ability to transfer genetic materials to plants or the ability of lentivirus to transfer genes to animal cells are natural examples of gene transfer. Bacteria were the first organism to be modified in the laboratory due to their simple genetics. These organisms are now used for several purposes and are particularly important in producing large amounts of pure human proteins for use in medicine. Genetically modified bacteria are used to produce the protein insulin to treat diabetes.
Similar bacteria have been used to produce clotting factors to treat hemophilia and human growth hormone to treat various forms of dwarfism. The first transgenic animal was a super mouse created by Ralph Brinster and Richard Parmeter in 1982. It was created by inserting a human growth hormone gene in mouse genome. The offspring was much larger than the parents. Mouse is a common animal that is used for transgenic experiment. Other animals include pig, goat, cow, sheep, fish, etc. The production of transgenic animals involves the following methodology. The first step is the construction of a transgene, and the transgene is made up of three parts: a promoter sequence, the gene to be expressed, and the termination sequence. The second step is the introduction of the foreign gene into the animal through pronuclear microinjection method or by embryonic stem cell method. In microinjection method, a female animal is superovulated and eggs are collected. The eggs are fertilized in vitro. The transgene containing solution is injected into the male pronucleus using a micropipette, and eggs with the transgenes are kept overnight in an incubator to develop to a 2-cell stage. The eggs are then implanted into the uterus of a pseudo-pregnant female, that is, the female which has been mated with a vasectomized male the previous night. The second method is the embryonic stem cell method. The transgenic animals can be created by manipulating embryonic stem cells. Embryonic stem cells are obtained from the inner cell mass of a blastocyst. Transgenes incorporated into the embryonic cell by microinjection, by a retrovirus, or by electroporation. Transgenic stem cells are grown in vitro and then they are inserted into a blastocyst and implanted into a host uterus to grow normally. Then is a screening procedure. The transgenic progenies are screened by PCR to examine the site of incorporation of the gene, and some transgenes may not be expressed if integrated into a transcriptionally inactive site. Further animal breeding is done to obtain maximal expression. Heterozygous offsprings are mated to form homozygous strains. Let's see some transgenic animals example. The first one is transgenic fish. The super fish, it is having increased growth and size, and growth hormone gene are inserted into fertilized egg. Transgenic salmon grows about 10 to 11 times faster than the normal fish. Then is a glowfish. It's a genetically modified freshwater zebra fish produced by integrating a fluorescent protein gene from jellyfish into embryo of the fish. So such a glowy appearance will be there. Transgenic mouse are especially used for the experimental or study purpose. The first one is the Alzheimer's mouse. In the brain of Alzheimer's patients, dead nerve cells are entangled in a protein called amyloid, and mouse made by introducing the amyloid precursor gene into fertilized egg of mice. Then there's the onco mouse. It's a mouse model to study cancer. It's made by inserting activated oncogenes. This is a smart mouse. It's a biological model engineered to overexpress NR2B receptor in the synaptic pathway, and this makes the mice learn faster like juveniles throughout their lives. The next one is a transgenic pig. The enviro pig, because these pigs have a trouble fully digesting a compound known as the phytate found in many cereal grains used to feed them. The transgenic pigs are created by introducing the phytase gene, which is taken from the bacteria E. coli. Phytase enzyme is produced in the salivary gland of pig, and it degrades indigestible phytate with the release of phosphate that is readily digested by the pigs. Then there are transgenic pigs that is developed for organ transplant. The pigs with human genes in order to decrease the chance of organ rejection by human body. Then there are transgenic cattle, the transgenic cows are made to produce proteins, lactoferrin and lactoferrin in their milk. Also, prion-free cows, that is resistant to mad cow disease. Then there is transgenic sheep, that is for good quality wool production. And there is transgenic goat that could express tissue plasminogen activator, antithrombin 3 and spider silk, etc. in milk. Next is a transgenic rabbit Alba, the enhanced green fluorescent protein bunny created in 2000 as a transgenic artwork. Then there is transgenic monkey Andy. It stands for inserted DNA when spelled backwards. An engineered virus was used to insert the harmless gene for green fluorescence protein into Andy's rhesus genome. Andy proves that transgenic primates can be created and can express a foreign gene delivered into their genome. So let's see the importance of transgenic animals. The medical importance include the disease model they are used for research and study purpose. And as a bioreactors for pharmaceuticals, for the production of pharmaceutical products. And in xenotransplantation, xenotransplantation is the transplantation of living cells or tissues or organs from one species to another. And the agriculture importance include the disease-resistant animals for improving the quality and quantity of milk, meat, eggs and wool production. And the industrial importance, the toxicity-sensitive transgenic animals to test chemicals and the spider silk in milk of goat. These silk protein from the goat's milk are used for a variety of applications due to its strength and elasticity. It have medical uses such as for the making artificial ligaments, tendons, for eye sutures, for jaw repair. And coming to its industrial importance, these are also used in bulletproof vest and improved car airbags.
Now let's see some of the common concerns that is associated with the genetic modification. The first one is the allergenicity. GM foods have the potential to cause allergic reaction in general, and this risk is comparable to the risk associated with traditionally grown food. However, the proteins produced by newly introduced genes have the potential to cause an additional allergic response. To prevent such allergenicity, the transfer of genes from commonly allergenic food is discouraged unless it can be proven that the protein produced by the introduced gene will not be allergenic. Another potential risk is the introduction of an entirely new protein that did not previously exist in the food chain. The next one is the gene transfer. The transfer of genetic material from genetically modified food to the cells of the human body or the bacteria in the intestinal tract. DNA from ingested food is not completely degraded by digestion, and small fragments of DNA from genetically modified food have been found in different parts of the gastrointestinal tract. This could result in horizontal gene transfer due to absorption of DNA fragments by gut microflora or somatic cells lining the intestinal cells. Scientists, however, postulated that the uptake of genetically modified DNA into the cells of the gastrointestinal tract will not have any biological consequences because this DNA will be degraded in the cell. The next one is the increase in anti-nutrients. These are substances that interfere with the utilization of nutrients, and the insertion of a new gene may lead to an increase in the existing level of anti-nutrients. For example, glyphosate-resistant Roundup Ready soybean has been shown to increase anti-nutrients. In sheep and cattle, heat-stable anti-nutrients such as phytoestrogens, glycinins, phytic acid have been found to be cause infertility, allergic reactions and decreased availability of phosphorus and zinc. The next concern is the use of viral DNA implants. Most GM crops utilize a cauliflower mosaic virus 35S promoter to switch on the introduced gene. And there's a controversy as to whether the CMV35S would be horizontally transferred and cause disease via carcinogenesis, mutagenesis, reactivation of dormant viruses or generation of new viruses. And let's see some of the pros of genetically modified food. They improve yield, more resistant to disease, less likely to be damaged by insect, tolerance to herbicides, better nutritional value, increased shelf life, improvement in health and environment, better climatic survival by increasing tolerance to drought, flood or frosty conditions to high crop yields, reduced farm cost, increased farm profit. Some of the criticism of GM foods are, the first one is related to environmental hazard is that the unintended harm to the other organisms, also reduced effectiveness of the pesticides, that is pesticide resistance develop, Then gene transfer to non-target species. That is, there are chances that crossbreeding occur, and transfer of herbicide resistance from crops to weeds will be a major problem. The super weeds will then have herbicide tolerance as well. The human health risk includes the allergenicity, as we discussed earlier, and other unknown effects on human health. And the economic concerns, like it's a lengthy and costly process. And the big companies like Monsanto, Novartis can patent their product and make profit by exporting them, but the farmers from developing countries cannot afford it. So there will be more gap between the rich and the poor. And in case of transgenic animals, it's like blurring the lines between the species by creating transgenic combinations. There may be health risks associated with transgenics, and there may be long-term effects on the environment when transgenic animals are released into the field. And various bioethicists argue that it is wrong to create animals that would suffer as a result of genetic alteration.